In this illustration, we'll analyze a cylinder spinning at a corner. We are given that a uniform cylinder of radius r is spinned about its axis at angular speed omega naught and then placed into a corner. And the coefficient of friction between cylinder wall and floor is given as mu. We are required to find the total number of turns cylinder will make before it stops. Now, in this situation, we can redraw the figure for analysis where we are given that the cylinder is rotating at angular speed omega naught, due to which it will experience a friction F2 and F1 over here. And the normal reactions acting at bottom is say N1 and on wall is say N2, and these will be passing through the center. Now, in this situation here, we can write as the central mass of cylinder is at rest. Here we use, in this situation we can write the value of N2 is equals to mu N1 in horizontal direction and in vertical direction. Say this is our equation 1. And in vertical direction we write N1 plus mu N2 is equals to mg. Say this is our equation 2. Now from these two equations here you can see, if we substitute the value of N2 over here, this becomes 1 plus mu square N1 is mg. So this gives us the value of N1, which is mg divided by 1 plus mu square. And the value of N2 is mu N1, so this mu mg divided by 1 plus mu square. So we have got the value of N1 and N2. So here we can calculate the angular retardation of a cylinder is, here cylinder will be having angular retardation due to the torque applied by these two frictions. So angular acceleration alpha we can write as torque due to friction divided by the moment of inertia. And the torque of friction we can write here as F1 plus F2 multiplied by R divided by the moment of inertia of cylinder is half mr square. Now, here the values of F1 and F2 we can write as mu N1 and mu N2. This will be mu N1 and this will be mu N2. So, if we substitute the values, this will give us 2 mu by R multiplied by 1 plus mu divided by 1 plus mu square multiplied by G, as M gets cancelled out. And this is the term which is left over. So the value of angular acceleration we are getting is 2 mu g by r multiplied by 1 plus mu upon 1 plus mu square. And if we calculate the angle which the cylinder will rotate before it will come to rest, then we can write by speed equation theta is equals to omega naught square by 2 alpha. So, here omega naught we are provided and alpha we have calculated. So, this gives us omega naught square by 2 alpha will be multiplied by r times 1 plus mu square divided by 4 mu g multiplied by 1 plus mu. Now, in this situation, as we have got the value of theta, here we can calculate the number of turns rotated by cylinder will be n, and that is equals to theta upon 2 pi, which is equals to omega naught square r multiplied by 1 plus mu square divided by 8 pi mu g multiplied by 1 plus mu. That is the result of this problem.